Hey, what's going on, friends and family? It's been a while. You know who it is. It's your boy Short. Just coming today, give you guys an update on what's been happening. As you can see, the garage is empty. So a lot of you guys might be asking, where is Polly Girl? Well, unfortunately, I blew the head gasket. I've had the car for about 24 years. And it's the original motor. I had the trans rebuilt on when I was bringing her back out, and now I figure just because I blew the head gasket, I might as well refresh that original 327 and the double hump camel heads that are in it. So what we're gonna do today is we're gonna go take a trip down to the shop where she's at and get an update. I'm gonna keep you guys posted on the rebuild of her motor. So everybody stay tuned. Thanks for following me. If you ain't already subscribed, subscribe to my channel. You know, give me thumbs up, circulate these videos, and let's get ready on this journey.
Yeah, when people see that, they might say, oh man, yeah, what is this? Can't really see them very well.
Well, when it's all clean, we'll be able to see it.
Yeah. Right.
So it looks like 3 7 8 2 8 7 0.
Yeah.
Or is that a 5 5 7, huh?
This one here, 8 8 7 0.
No, but
oh, this one, right?
Yeah. Kind of looks like a 5, huh? 5 7 8 2 8 8 7 0 2 8 7 0 7. Okay. Can you spin it around so I can see the bottom part, like where the oil pan would be on it?
Yep.
Okay. Yeah, I appreciate this, man. It's just because I want to document everything on it.
Yeah.
That way, my son will always have record for it.
Yeah.
Paula Girl's engine block, JoJo. These are all her existing inner parts. It's just a blown head gasket. But what we are gonna do is a full rebuild. Thank you. But they look good.
So they look good, doesn't have any cracks. So after we clean them up, we're gonna recheck it again.
Okay. And where's the casting number on this?
This one's there over here on top. Casting number is right here. Switch it around. Yeah, right here. The 460 one, that's a very popular.
That's for the double hump camel heads, right?
Yeah.
The original double hump camel heads and my original 327 small block Chevy motor. You guys know who it is? Paula Girl. Paula Girl getting all cleaned up, getting ready for paint. Stay tuned, keep following the videos. You mind being on camera? This is the maestro right here. This is Javier from CV Automotive Machine Shop. He's the one bringing Paula Girl back to life.
All right.
All right.
I don't mind being in the picture. No.
Here goes a block, man. Bare block right here. Good news. She's good. She's already been rebuilt one time that I wasn't aware of. She was 40 over. So the maestro right here, Javier, said we're probably gonna go 60 over on her. She's gonna be like brand new. I know she ain't much to look at, but for all the car guys know what we're looking at. That's a real 327, 65 before 68, so we know what we got here. And one more time, hey Javier, thank you, man.
Welcome.
What's going on, friends and family? These are my headers. I know they're a little beat up, but me, I'm kind of sentimental. So what I'm gonna do is try to bring them back to life. Eventually, I'm gonna have to buy some new ones because looking at them, they're a little messed up. But what I am gonna do is I just like documenting everything. Again, I'm sentimental to hold on to stuff for Paula Girl. You can see she's pretty scraped up right here. But I'm going to bring these pipes back to life, man. Because when I got her, this is what was in her. You know what I'm saying? And a long time ago, I had bought some chrome Doug Thorleys. But I wasn't knowledgeable about that if you had power steering or whatever. And the pipes that I ended up having didn't have power steering. So they didn't fit on the driver's side. Let me flip this over so you guys can look at them. That way we have everything documented, man. I'm gonna try to bring them back to life. They're just gonna be around for a little bit. Eventually, I'm gonna break bread and have to buy me some chrome ones because she's gonna be looking really, really shiny inside when I get done with the rebuild of her motor. All right, everybody. I hope you guys enjoy the video. I know it might not look like much. Just want to give you a before and after from after hitting it with the wire wheel on a drill. You can see I knocked off most of the old corrosion. I haven't hit this one yet. But hopefully you guys can see the difference. And I'm just hitting it with a drill, wire wheel, and another kind of wire wheel. Just knocking everything off. I'll show you guys again. I know you guys don't want to watch and see me hit it with the wire wheel, so stay tuned.
Roll another one. Sit up, never like you know it, but you pack it with the motor magnets. We gon' sit up to have it.
What it do though, man? It's your boy Short again. Looking a little scruffy because I'm working on Paula Girl though. You guys can see her. I'm gonna show you what I've been doing. Sanded everything down, gunked it all out, pressure washed it, and then excuse the train that's going by. And then blew her all out, and then I painted her whole engine bay. So I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys that right now. So here we go. This is Paula Girl right here. I don't know if you guys could tell from the other shots, but yeah, to me, oh yeah, that sounds nice. To me, she's looking beautiful. It's just a satin black, you know, a flat black, just to make everything pop when we put this engine back up in her. Got down all on the bottom, made sure she's all nice and looking brand new. So then again, stay tuned, watch the video. I hope you guys learn something, or at least I hope you enjoy it. It's a learning process as we go through this together. All right, talk to you guys on the next one. Hey, there we go with Paula's block right here, getting reboard. Last one on this side. So basically what this does is kind of drills it out, or machines it.
Yeah, that's correct. It drills it out one way around.
Makes the cylinder walls all brand new. Cool, pretty interesting, man. This process makes it from this to brand new like this. And again, we're going, it's going to be 60 over, right, Javier?
Yeah, 60 over.
Okay. Yeah, because she was once rebuilt prior to me having her. Sorry for the guys watching this video if I sound like I'm repeating myself, but she was 40 over. So there's enough material, or like I said, enough meat on the bone. Javier said we'll be fine going 60 over. She's just going to be a cruiser anyway. So it ain't like we're going to be burning anything up. Get a shot of this in a minute. Let's take a look. Oh yeah, like brand new. Nice. All nicely ready to go, ready for paint. Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your boy Short, back with some more on this video. As you can see behind me, got Paula Girl right here in the back. I'm here at the shop, and I know you guys don't want to see me, but we're here painting her block. I just got done painting the block, peeling all the masking tape off to protect the internal parts. So let me flip this around and show you the outcome of the block. I went with it's a Pontiac Baby Blue Metallic. I'll show you the can in this too. I'm pretty happy with the results. The color's kind of close to what I'm gonna end up painting her. All right, so let me flip this around. As we walk up, you can already see, I don't know, the sun might be messing it up, but let me walk up on her. I'm pretty happy with the outcome of it. Again, you can see parts where I had it masked off at. I just pulled all the tape off and everything. But she's coming out lovely, real shiny. Got a little metallic in her. As you can see, it's close to the color of the car. Don't mind that timing chain cover. I just had it on there to protect the inner part, so there's some overspray. She's gonna have a chrome timing chain cover on her, and yeah, I'm pretty happy. She does look nice. She's coming out nice, man. She's already been bored out. And for everybody that's wondering, this is what I'm using. Now the cap don't really do justice of the color that's on the block. It's kind of close. Let me hold it up here in the light. But again, it's just some rattle cans. And it's the Pontiac light blue metallic. Let me see if I can focus the, so that way in case anybody's wondering. I hope you guys can see it. Right here we have all her internal parts right here. New cam. There's some rods, bearings, you know, all the stuff that's gonna be going in her. But again, hope you guys enjoyed the video. Stay tuned for more to come. Please subscribe, like, and share this, man, because this is what keeps these videos circulating. You guys have a good day. Just a real quick short video of my water pump. It's an aluminum AC Delco, so she was already aluminum. I'm just going to protect the metal and spray a clear on her so she don't rust up on us. You know, over time she might rust up. So I'm just spraying some clear on her. It's the Rust-Oleum 2K, just clear. All right, guys, quick video. Stay tuned for more to come. Think about doing this on my intake manifold too. All right, later.